Hey guys, it's HoppingHammy. Today's video, I'm going to be telling you how I spot clean my hamster's cage. Now, spot cleaning is a term that a lot of hamster owners use, and you may wonder what it means, like what exactly is spot cleaning and how does it differ from a regular cleaning. So I'm going to be talking a little bit about that today. Now, the info I'm going to be sharing with you is just how I spot clean. It's not like the rule or like how you have to spot clean or anything like that. It's just what I found has worked really well for me. But I'm going to be showing you this cage today because I recently moved Ginger Snap in here and it hasn't even been a week and he's already messed the cage up. So I'm just going to show you sort of how I tidy it up. So we will go ahead and get started. So I am just going to give you a brief overview of his cage. It's kind of hard to tell how messy it is because it looked so nice previously. But for starters, I have all of this toilet paper that I gave to him, which you can see it's kind of all over the place and it just looks really messy. It's mixed in with the Timothy hay. And then over here we have a little plant that knocked over. You can see some mess in the blue Carefresh. And then his wheel, it's hard to tell, but he has peed on it a little bit, so I'm definitely going to take that out and wash it. Over here in this corner, you can definitely see that his sand pit is in need of changing. You can see all the little poops in it. And then behind that, I have these little willow sticks that were previously stacked up all nice and neat, and you can see he sort of had a party and threw them everywhere. Yeah, it's basically, it's kind of just looks really messy, and I like my cages to look neat, so I'm gonna go ahead and start on this and try to tackle it. So the first thing I will work on is cleaning out the sand dish. Now, I don't throw out all of the sand, I just use this little pink scooper, which has a sifter, and that way I can sift through the wet sand and the debris that is in there, and just clean it out that way. Now, oftentimes what I'll do to clean the rest of the cage is I will put some plastic gloves on, and that way I can just pick around and not have to worry about getting anything gross under my fingernails or whatever, and it's just more hygienic that way, so I'm just going to tidy up the area now. Okay, so it's not perfect, I'll admit, but it is much cleaner than it was previously, and it just looks a lot better now. So I'm going to move on to picking up the toilet paper now. So here is an overview of how it looks after I tidied it up, and you can see that everything is pretty much back in its place now. I'll just give you a quick overview. You can see there's no longer bedding that is mixed in the water. His nest area is tidied up, there's not toilet paper everywhere. This pond is clean, and his wheel is clean, and of course his sand pit is very clean. I also changed his water bottle, so that's basically just how I spot clean. I just pick different areas and tidy them up, and if there's any dirty bedding or wet bedding, you want to remove that as well, but you don't have to take all of the bedding out because not every spot gets soiled. But when you do a full clean at that point, then you will probably remove most of the bedding, but you will probably want to save a little bit to sprinkle.